Yo, what is up, guys? It's your boy Jelson here, and today we're back at it with a brand new NBA video for you guys. We're on a roll here, 4 days in a row now, and in today's video we're going to be talking about another team in the NBA's future series. This is chapter 3, the Phoenix Suns. Roll the intro. There's a few things I want to talk about in today's video regarding the Phoenix Suns, a team that had made the finals this year but unfortunately lost to Milwaukee. So you may be wondering, why is this in your NBA Futures series? Well, that's a great question, because even though they made the finals, it does not discredit them from the series. I actually want to talk about this because they are part of this future. They are part of the future that relates to the Timberwolves, to the Hornets. Those two videos I posted previously in this series, they're related to it. Just because they make the finals doesn't mean they're not part of the future. Obviously, every team is technically part of the future, but what teams are going to make an impact in the future is the question, and that's what this series is about. And with guys like Devin Booker and DeAndre Ayton and guys like that, this team is going to be around for a long time, as long as they can make money work with their players like Cam Johnson, those role players, those guys that are key to this team's success, Mikal Bridges, other guys like that. Obviously, Chris Paul being their point guard, you know, he's an older guy, a guy that his contract is now up. I would not be surprised if he re-signs with the Suns, and if he doesn't, I think that's kind of stupid. But unless he's going ring chasing and goes to the Lakers, I think he re-signs with the Suns. But hey, man, Chris Paul, go get you a bag. That's what I was going to say. Go get your ring. You know, Chris Paul, do your thing. Go play with your best friend in LeBron. But hey, this Suns team is still going to be around, even if they don't have Chris Paul next year. And I want to say that because Devin Booker, obviously a lot of people compare him to Kobe Bryant. I don't like comparing people to Kobe Bryant, considering Kobe Bryant is Kobe Bryant and Devin Booker is Devin Booker. They're two separate entities and two separate players. You know, you could say that he reminds you of somebody, but I can't say he is this type of person. Like, he plays like him. Like, he reminds me of him, but he isn't the exact same player. Devin Booker hits clutch shot after clutch shot, and that's just what he's known for. He had 71 points. 71! Is that not insane to you guys? 71 points. That's crazy. Obviously, a few years ago, he was even younger than he is now. He's still super young now. DeAndre Ayton, another guy that's super young, a few years younger than Devin Booker, a guy, number one overall pick out of Arizona. Hey, those Arizona boys, they know what they're doing. You know, I would be wearing my Phoenix Suns hat if my head wasn't so large and it looked like I had a diaper on my head. That's not an insult to the Suns, that's an insult to my melon, the size of this head. But yeah, guys, what do you guys think about the Suns? So the Suns are a very interesting team to me and a lot of other people in the community. I want to know you guys' thoughts down in the comments. Obviously, they have guys like Mikal and Cam Johnson, these guys that I've talked about in the past and guys that I've talked about earlier in this video. These guys are the glue pieces that are really important. And for this team to continue into the future, to the future where we have that Timberwolves time frame and the Hornets time frame, we need to secure those players. You need to secure the players like Mikal and Cam, obviously DeAndre and Devin Booker. Those type of guys are very important to a franchise. You know, Campaign came out and played. Man was a baller in the playoffs. Another guy that you hope to retain for the future. Campaign, a guy that was out of the league for a minute there and came back and had a resurgence in his career. Obviously, was never a great ball player. Well, he's in the NBA, so he's a great ball player, but in NBA terms, he was never a great ball player until this season. He came back and showed what he was worth. And keeping those core guys, those five players that I named just then and there, those guys are just a few of those players that you would love them to retain. And a few guys that I would argue are the most important pieces to a franchise. Those guys that you draft later on in the rounds, and later on in the picks, and you find core guys that could produce. Think about it. Devin Booker, a guy that was drafted later in the first round. Obviously, I'm pretty sure he was still a lottery pick. A guy like Devin Booker, a guy that is a superstar. There is no doubt about that. A superstar in Devin Booker. A guy like Cam Johnson, a guy that was drafted later, I believe pick 11. A guy that everybody did not believe in and believed that he was picking too early. And I was one of those people, and I was wrong. The Suns knew what they were doing. I didn't. There's a reason I'm not a GM. There's a reason I'm a guy on the internet talking about basketball. Like, think about it. The Suns are drafting ridiculously well recently and picking up free agents that you guys would have never thought would make an impact. You know, grabbing Torrey Craig, a guy that looked like his career was going to be done after leaving the Bucks. He comes to the Suns, you know, obviously wasn't a great offensive player, but he hustled, did the defense, did all the rebounding. He did the dirty work, man. Torrey Craig was a steal for them. Obviously, he reminds me a lot like Jared Vanderbilt for the Timberwolves, a guy that's going to get the job done if you need him to. I could see this team being around for quite a while if they keep their core guys. This is a relatively short video. If you guys did enjoy this video, please like and subscribe. You know, this is where I would make a Suns in 13 playoff joke, finals joke, but you know, I'm gonna skip on it this time. Anyway, guys, hopefully you guys did enjoy. Remember to like and subscribe. I'll see you guys in the next video. Peace.